Hi, good morning to all. Now we are studying about the .NET technology, in which we will start with .NET framework. Let's try to understand the .NET framework. Our course objectives are to learn the basic .NET framework, to understand the .NET framework architecture. So these are the basic preliminary requirement to go ahead into the .NET technology. So first try to understand with the .NET framework. So there are some certain key points in which we will try to understand the .NET introduction, the features of the .NET, .NET framework, understand the motivation behind this particular .NET platform. And we'll try to understand the .NET framework architecture with specific diagrams, and what are the different type of components which are involved in to make it this a robust architecture. We will try to understand, and afterwards we will learn about the common type systems. So what is .NET? I can say that .NET is not any kind of a language. It's a kind of a framework, and this provides a particular platform to support the different type of languages. And as per the Microsoft, it supports more than 18 languages right now, and has the C# language, VB, C++, COBOL, Python, Java. These all are the platforms which is supported by the .NET framework. So it's a kind of a robust development and runtime environment. It provides a fast web and desktop application building criterias. It has a very good memory management and the type verification system by use of the CTS. So with this particular example, we can understand that it is a .NET platform which is supported by the CLR and very well is to be supported by the CTS. That is called Common Type System. And this common type system is a part of your common language specifications. And over all these kind of a build up, it is being supported by the various type of operating system that is called Windows, Linux, Macintosh, OS and all. So we can develop such kind of an application with the help of those different operating system levels. So it has some basic features which is supported by the OOPS concept, that is the most important concept, and it also supports the multi-language. It is supporting to the multi-devices. It has automatic memory management system. It is having with a very good XML support, and the ease of deployment and the security configuration is also an enhanced feature under the .NET platform. So you can develop a number of applications like Windows application, web applications, mobile applications. These are the basic chunks of an applications which is created by using the .NET. So what exactly the .NET framework? So .NET framework is a software development framework. It is a .NET programs which can be executed and with the help of the CLR. And it provides that IDE environment in which you can create your own blocks of programs, and you can integrate it with each other with the help of user interfaces, the database connectivity, some of the cryptographic techniques. One is the security, one is the, that is a very good enhanced security criteria related with the web applications deployment as well. You can have into this .NET framework. So it is a kind of a framework which is supported by the different languages. So there is a JIT compiler which is available into the .NET platform, which has a duty to convert the entire code into the MSIL code. Then afterwards, when you execute that particular MSIL code, then according to the machine instructions, it basically convert into the native code of that particular machine. So in that scenario, it is very much robust and applicable for the different type of machines. So here you can understand with the .NET framework architecture diagram. it's very easy to understand that in the base level you are having a CLR, and above the CLR you are having a base class library, and the base class library is having a build up on with data and XML. Why the data and XML? XML is a cross language support language that is called extended markup language, and which is acceptable by all across different types of technical capabilities with across the different type of technology domains. So that's why XML is heavily used, and it is having a very good support on that. It also provides data movement very efficiently, and with the help of the different type of SQL queries, with the help of different type of stored procedures, and it make it lightweighted application as well. It supports the different web services. Through the web services you can connect with the different type of platforms, and like in banking type of applications with your AWS, with the other web services which can be a part of the integration system in your .NET platform. As well as you do have the common language specification which supports the different type of languages such as that VB.NET, C#, C++, Perl, Python, Java, as I already told earlier. So these all are the architecture which has been supported. So it has some basic components. One most important concept are the components, you can say that is the common type system. The common type system is basically allows the entire program is to be converted into a same language platform. Okay, if suppose you are using the C# language, then on the basis of the supportability, you need to create all the entire application with respect to that particular language and its data types. So that's why the common type system allows you to write in one language to be used and extended by the another language. In such case, that particular code is to be said as the managed code, as well as if you will make use the other languages inside that particular framework, so then in such cases that code becomes unmanaged code. So when you do the CLR, which is to be taken care by the .NET platform, so when you do the compilation, the entire code is to be converted into a single type system. So that is called the common type system. So that's why the CLR is having an important role to convert the entire code, or you can say the entire unmanaged code, into the managed code. So that is the beauty of the common type system. So similarly, as we understood about the CLS, because of it is providing or it is supporting to the different language platforms. So that's why in a single platform also you can able to use the multi-language platforms. So common type system, it has a following function. You can see here that it establishes a framework that helps to enable the cross-language integration. It provides the type safety and high performance code execution. So as I already spoken about it, it's converted into the different type system into the same native type system. So moving ahead, what type of applications which can be developed into this particular .NET platform? Yes, you can understand with the development of the ASP.NET web applications, Windows form based application, console applications, different type of component libraries you can add it. You can create your own customs controls which can be helpful into the form designing as per your need, or even though you can provide into the Google Microsoft Play Store as well. And apart from that, you do have the Windows services for the different type of integration purpose. You can create the Windows services. You can have the web services also. You can develop some web custom controls as well. So these all are the different type of applications which you can develop with the help of the .NET platform. So like we can understand in detail that ASP.NET application is basically used for the web application development, as well as the Windows application is to be created for the Windows environment itself. So web application can be handled by the URL, but in the Windows application you need to install it individually over the Windows, which is to be available to the client machines. Similarly, you can have the console application. So you rather than providing the graphical interface, you can also make use out of console application to build up the small logical programs, as well as you can have some kind of a log system, or you can have some command type systems that you can make use with the help of console applications. So web services, you can enable the web services which is to be requested as per the HTTP request. Then the ASP.NET or other applications which are URL based, that you can provide those web services to those applications which can be make use of the integration with the other applications. And apart from that, it has a component libraries, and in that particular component libraries you can create a multiple different type of classes and the platforms which has some kind of a namespaces, which have they can have the classes, member methods, and other components. And in a single component you can create the different type of logics as well, and it will be act as a middle tier application in the overall different applications. So these are all are the different topics which we have covered as an introduction, and these all are the online references which you can refer it, and the definitely you can have the references books, so you can follow that reference books to understand the concepts of the .NET framework. So if you have any query, you can ask me, and you can write me over my mail ID vikas.srivastava@galgotiasuniversity.edu.in. so if you do have any query, you can write me mail. Thank you for watching me and to understand this concept. Thank you.